I have personally worked over the years on countless companies that are looking to make a positive impact on the world. I've helped them to scale their sales into the millions, and I've followed a particular formula to achieve this, and I've seen it be consistent across every single one of these businesses.
Whoa, hey, come on.
It's quite unique to businesses trying to make the world better, especially this kind of unique approach that I'm about to reveal, and I hope it helps you. So without further ado, let's get into it. My name is Max Sinclair, I'm the founder of Snowball Creations. I run a paid ads agency, so that's why I know about this stuff. And yeah, let's dig into what is this adjustment to this formula? How are you going to scale to the millions that you should be for your positive impact business? So let's start firstly with the problem. The problem that I see pretty much everybody that starts working with us, there is the exceptions. We see the occasional company come to us who are already seeing great results and we're just trying to improve on them. But very often this is missed. The problem is people write their copy, they write their messaging with that positive impact in mind, because that's of course their entire business. That's their unique selling point. Let's say for example, one of our clients is a waste management company. They might start with the message that we help companies to shift from landfill to recycling and to reusing all of this kind of waste. This is an amazing positive impact story. Or let's say we have another company we work with who are in the eco product space. So their message might be with their compostable sponges that this is an eco-friendly alternative, so you don't have to waste these kinds of plastic, throw away these plastic sponges consistently, and so it's a more environmentally friendly solution. So they focus on those two messages and they think that that's how they're going to achieve the best results because it's the USP, so that makes sense and that's what you're taught. And for lots of reasons that should logically be the way forward. But it doesn't work. Why does it not work? The reason why it does not work, the harsh truth of this, is that it is focusing on the selfless first. So ultimately, with any positive impact business, you need to make sure that selfishly, it also still does improve that person's life or give some kind of value to the entire process.
I know this sounds awful, but I'm going through a selfish phase right now.
Any business that's in the positive impact space that really can scale and make sure that its impact is long-term has to figure this out and has to make sure that they have got value beyond just the sustainability factor, at least in my experience. So what is the solution to this problem? The solution is switching this around. So you have the selfless value, which would be say less landfill waste, or the selfless argument with the eco product company of no more plastic sponges going into waste, into the oceans. That could be the selfless. But then there's the selfish part to this. So for the waste management company, it could be actually just that they have the best customer service. They've completely reinvented the customer service side of things with their business model too. And that entire industry is famous for having terrible, terrible customer experience. And so that's actually one of their big wins, and they're extremely affordable and like reliable. Or the other one, the eco-friendly product company. So they sell sponges, these sponges. What's the selfish side of this? The selfish side is they're actually just way nicer to use. Maybe they're better on your hands to use. Maybe they do a better job of actually cleaning up. All of these factors. So these are the, or it could even just be the positive feeling of using that product instead of the plastic. So this is the selfish reason. So the way that we adjust things with our formula is really just switching this around. So rather than having your benefit be the selfless first, and then you have some selfish stuff afterwards, the benefits, you switch that around. So you have the selfish stuff first, which is, you know, this is just a better sponge. You're gonna have an easier time. You're gonna have a great time. It's gonna be the best dishwashing you've ever done with this sponge. Or you are gonna have no more headaches with your waste management company as your restaurant owner or something. No more your tips or your dumpster's gonna be overflowing with rubbish. All of these amazing things are selfish reasons why these customers are gonna be so happy and excited and gonna choose to click on your advert in Facebook or LinkedIn, or click on your responsive text ad within Google Ads.
Wow.
These selfish reasons first, and then you still have the selfless reasons. So generally speaking, you're going to have two parts to the message. Like, for example, world-class leading, or like transforming the customer service side of waste management and reducing landfill to zero or something. So you start with the selfish and you follow up with the selfless. The reason for this is people are selfish first. This is a really harsh truth of the world. But if you're a positive impact company and you're trying to scale, you can't hide and just pretend that this isn't a reality. To be very clear, we've got to this conclusion because we have run campaigns, like I say, for many years now, countless different brands. I used to run an ecotourism company and I learned it first from that business, that it's just the truth. Like, we've A/B tested this across Facebook, Google, LinkedIn, and many other places, in events, in any other format within the copy, and we've seen it consistently win out. And that's A/B testing, data-driven decision-making. So it's just a fact. It's a fact of nature. So recognize this, embrace it, and actually, this will still lead to the biggest, best impact that you're trying to achieve anyway. You as a business, you're trying to build this business that has this positive impact on the world. If your business goes under, you have zero impact on the world. Well done. The impact, the problem that you're trying to solve is going to be left still impacting things terribly. Especially this is like, you know, landfill, continuously existing companies just throwing waste into landfill, or people just never quite improving on their products at home. These sound like quite small day-to-day things. But many businesses doing many of these amazing kind of like business opportunities can be transformative on the world, and it's how humanity is going to go the right direction. So understanding how you can write copy in a different way is actually pivotal, and accepting that the selfish side of this, maybe it doesn't feel nice, but ultimately it's what's going to get people to click, and it's what's going to get people to change their actions and feelings and emotions. And once you've got that person, then they've become a customer. The other stuff is extremely important. So you get their attention with the selfish, but you keep them sticky. You build a relationship with the selfless, because that's what really gives them that good feeling in the long term. So selfish first, selfless second. Hopefully you found this of useful. And if you have, please do hit that subscribe button. It makes me very happy every single time. And it's really for people. This channel is made for people that are running businesses or involved in marketing, and they're trying to get better to scale their business to whole new heights. I love to help people with that. So yeah, please do hit that subscribe button. And otherwise, I will see you next Wednesday. Thank you.